Hello everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Cordell Felix, and on this video, I will show you how to make quick and easy edge scratches for a texture in Photoshop CS6. I will be showing you how to use the ambient occlusion map of a model and turn it into an edge map to use as a base to get in some quick scratches on the model. I use this technique on any model that needs some roughing up or is just generally dirty. It will help add a lot of wear and tear to a model very quickly. I will be using Photoshop CS6 for this tutorial, and we'll show the applied scratches on this 3D model in 3ds Max 2013. The only thing you will need for this will be a grunge type brush in Photoshop. Just about any grungy brush should work for this technique. For the setup, I will be using my sci-fi beer cooler to apply this technique to. I already have the diffuse, specular, and normal map applied to this model in this scene. I will just be adding the edge scratches on top of the diffuse. Let's hop into Photoshop, where I have the high poly ambient occlusion map already sitting on top of everything in the layers. This works with low poly ambient occlusion as well, but I recommend you use the high poly ambient occlusion map since it holds more detailed edge information. We will be using a couple of the Photoshop filters here located at the top. I'm going to go ahead and make a copy of the high poly ambient occlusion map because I want it to be non-destructive and I want to be able to go back to that if I need to. So to start, we need to go to Filter, Stylize, and Fine Edges. This should turn all your edges black, and you can see that it pretty much got almost every edge there and it has all that information still there, so it's pretty nice. The next thing we need to do is to invert the image, so it will turn those edges to white. Now we need to get these edges to look more like scratches. Right now they're very straight and not very convincing. So in order to get them to look like scratches, we can use a filter for that. So go to Filter, Filter Gallery, and here you'll see a bunch of different folders that give you different styles of overlays pretty much. So I use the splatter map, and make sure it's under splatter here, and I use a radius of 3 and 7. If you bump up the radius, it should get a lot more rugged and that just doesn't look too good, so I'm just gonna keep it at 3 and 7 now. So with that applied, it messed them up a lot, and we can start to use this as a base and work from there. The next step is to isolate the white from the black. To do so, we want to go to the layer style by double-clicking on the layer in this open area. If you double-click on the text, it'll rename it, so make sure you double-click here. Once you open that, you will get the layer style menu, and we want to get rid of the black. So here's the blend if bar, and you want to mess with the top value, and just if you bring that down, it'll start to get rid of all the black there. And you can use this with other textures too. If there's a pure color, say if I wanted to get rid of the white, I would use this white side, and you can start to see through there. So we wanted to get rid of the black, so let's bring that down. That's pretty good. Now that the white scratches are isolated, we want to have them on their own layer. The layer still has the information of the black behind it, so we can go in there and bring it back, but I want them to be on their own. So we want to create a new layer by clicking this new page here, and we want to merge the two. So in order to merge both of them, you can select both of the layers by holding Control, and then hit Control E. That will merge the two together. And now the white scratches are completely on their own. There is no more black background, and we cannot bring it back. Now that we have the white scratches on their own, we want to make sure that everything here is going to be on the lighter side. You can still see that there are some black scratches, gray scratches, and stuff, but we want to get those all to be white. So in order to do so, you can hit Control U, which will bring up this menu, the Hue, Saturation, and Lightness. And now I want to crank this up all the way, which will make everything white. Hit OK to apply those settings. So now we want to smoothen out these edges a bit, because they are very pixely and very just rough. So in order to make them a little bit more smooth, we can use a filter for that. And go to Blur, or Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and have the value at 0.5. And this will smooth out the edges a lot, and we'll use some more techniques to make it look a bit better. The next step is to use the Unsharp Mask to eliminate any blurriness. So to use the Unsharp Mask, we go to Filter, Render, Sharpen, Unsharp Mask, and that'll bring this to this menu, which will generally thicken the lines a little bit, and it will completely eliminate the blurriness to them. I have the radius set to 150. You can mess with this value. Less is makes them less thick and a little bit more blurry. Somewhere around 150 is just fine. So hit OK. That's pretty much the last step of using the filters. So now our next step is to get these scratches to look a bit more realistic. We can't really use it right now because the scratches are everywhere, they're at full value, and we want to put them in just desired areas. So I know that on my model, there's some scratches where I know that where they could go and where they shouldn't go, like in these middle areas underneath this bridge thing. I generally want scratches right here, maybe here, some in the front here, and just any corner or anywhere that I want to just look rugged. I mean, maybe this thing fell over and just on concrete. So now we want to get rid of the edges by adding a mask. So by adding a mask, it'll give us that new mask layer. And in order to get rid of them, I'm going to fill the layer with black. So hit G for the bucket and click once to get rid of all the edges. Don't worry, they're still there. Black will erase and the white color will bring back. So if I fill this with white, it'll bring the edges back and fill it with black again. So I want to use a grungy brush. I'm going to hit B. You can look for any grunge brush that you want. Hopefully you have your own. If you don't, I recommend just Googling Photoshop grungy brushes and you'll find some sort of download. But this one works for me, so I'm going to use this one. So again, using the white and black, white brings back the edges and black will erase the edges. So you got to make sure that you are on your mask here, and I'm going to just start painting in the scratches. So I know my unwrap pretty well, and hopefully you do too. I modeled this guy and packed him, so generally I know where everything is. So I already mentioned where I want the scratches to go, and I'm going to do some on the front here. So I'm going to paint in some scratches right here using the grunge brush and the white. So if I just click and drag, you can see some of the scratches coming back. I can go around and just do this, but I'm going to be a little bit more careful. So I'm going to use the black to kind of erase some of this again. And just be creative with it. It's a really easy process. So I went ahead and added scratches to most of the texture. And I just wanted to make a quick note on when I do add these scratches back in, that I add them back in at a full value, and then I feather out the edges with the black brush. So I'll just do a quick example of that. So as you see, usually when you bring in the scratches, they're very white, it's just too much. So once you do that, just kind of make it like a good fall off, so that way the scratch just looks a bit more realistic. I'm going to save out the texture to apply it to the model now, to check that the scratches were applied in the right areas, make sure all the scratches make sense. So I'm going to save it out. Let's go to File, Save As, and say this is Targa. So go there and overwrite my existing file. And just go into 3ds Max, and it should pop over. There we go. Now let's check on the model and make sure that the scratches are all in places that make sense. I don't want any scratches in areas that are just like in large surface areas like this and underneath things. Generally, there should be scratches and that kind of stuff. So you can see that the scratches that I added, they stick out pretty nicely, like along these edges here, on these faces here. If any scratches are not where they should be, just go ahead and go into Photoshop and paint them back out. And that about wraps up this quick tip. My name is Cordell Felix, and thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.